Welcome to this week's Read Aloud about the Oregon Trail. Our interactive read aloud this week is called Wagons Ho, Then and Now on the Oregon Trail. It is a picture book that contrasts and compares the experiences of two young girls traveling on the Oregon Trail, one in 1846 by covered wagon and one in current times by car. The author is George Halliwell and Joan Holub, and the illustrator is Lynn Avril. Here, they show a map of two different pictures of what the United States looked like. On the left, we see what the United States looked like in 1846, and you can see that much of the West was still unexplored or not as populated, and the many of the current states that we currently have in the United States had not been formed yet. The map on the right shows what the United States looks like now, and it shows the route of the Miller family, how they traveled along the Oregon Trail in current times. Wagons Ho, 1846 and now. Would you have dared go west in 1846? If you had, you'd be in for a long, dusty, tiring, flat, mountainous, wet, dry, boring, exciting, fun, terrifying trip. By land, you'd travel on the Oregon Trail, the longest trail in North America. In 1846, it would have taken you 5 days to travel as far as we can drive in 1 hour today. So why would you go? Maybe you heard that a great migration to the West began in 1843 when 900 settlers traveled the Oregon Trail. Before that, the trail was only a rough path used by Native Americans and fur traders. At that time, Oregon didn't even belong to the United States. England wanted it too. Maybe you heard that pioneers were getting 640 free acres just for settling there. That much land was worth $800 in some parts of the United States. That was a lot of money in those days, when farmhands earned about $75 in a whole year. Or maybe you'd go because you heard the farmland was fertile, or because you believe the wild stories about Oregon being an almost magical, perfect place. You'd probably start your trip in Independence, Missouri, and end about 2,000 miles west in the Oregon country. You'd leave in April or May. By then, snow would have melted and the trail wouldn't be too muddy. Grass would be growing so you could feed your livestock. You'd go with other pioneers because that was safer. Most stories about trouble with Native Americans weren't true, but there were other dangers such as wild animals, bad weather, and accidents. You'd follow streams and rivers so you'd have water. Your wagon could go about 15 miles each day. If it rained, mud would make it hard to go even 1 mile. You'd better hope you'd make it to the trail's end by September. Otherwise, you might get snowed in among the mountains and freeze or starve to death. Still, like most pioneers, you'd probably think the new life you had found for yourself and your family was worth it in the end.